This is the SAP Developer News for June the 12th, 2025.
Hello, developers and CAP enthusiasts. Welcome and greetings of the day. I have some exciting updates for you today. CAP major release for May 2025 is now available. At first, we have updates for the new major versions. This includes version 9 for CAP Node.js with the changes in the minimum required Node.js version 20. With this release, CDS 7 has reached the end of life and it won't be patched any longer. This release brings new major version 4 for Java, including several enhancements and new features to improve the development experience. CAP Java 2.1.0 has also reached end of life and would require you to upgrade to a newer release. Next up, we have the information for the most important changes that CAP developers need to be aware of while upgrading to the major version. Be sure to check all the details while migrating to the new version. All the CAP Node.js packages and Java libraries now come with a new SAP Developer License 3.2 CAP that allows customers of SAP BTP or any SAP platform to use CAP applications productively and request support. Then we have the common configuration for hierarchical tree views, which is available in beta 2 release for CAP Node.js and Java. There is added support for SQLite and Postgres. Transactional event queues have been introduced to enhance the processing of events and requests to so-called queued services. You can find more details about how it works in Node.js and in Java in the release page. Coming to CDS language and compiler updates, we have a new CDS parser which is faster, has 40% reduced installation size with enhanced code completion. There is now out-of-box support for agnostic database functions, which are a set of standard functions inspired by OData and SAP HANA. CAP consistently supports the operator equal to and not equal to, and the behavior of these have slightly changed. There are a few more miscellaneous updates in CDS language and compiler topic related to nesting definitions, generated entities and annotation, @cds.persistence.journal, and syntax cleanup. Important changes include updates on association to many without on conditions, virtual elements in views, change semantics of the $now in CDS model, and doc comments that are no longer propagated. Next, coming to the database updates, we have faster deployment of SAP HANA tables using alter table add column. CDS associations are no longer reflected in the database tables and views by the native HANA associations as they are no longer needed by the CAP framework. HDB CDS format has been removed and it can no longer be used. Updates for Node.js include improved error handling with the support for the code property in the error response, support for the tree view with SQLite and PostgreSQL, new database services V2, and open-sourced CDS test package. Then we have a list of removed features and important changes in the Node.js and CAP Java. Updates for the tools include richer tooltip in CDS editor, which shows detailed documentation on Hoover, and compact formatting for case expressions. For multi-tenancy, important changes include changes in configuration, Java setup, and extensibility. Updates on CAP plugins include SAP Cloud Application Event Hub plugin that helps distribute business events across the SAP Cloud landscape, and SAP Integration Suite Advanced Events Mesh plugin that enables applications to engage in real-time asynchronous communication across distributed environments. And finally, we have a guide for microservices with CAP that shows how to deploy multiple Node.js applications that share one database schema. Please visit the May CAP release page to find more details. Links will be included in the description.
You all know the tutorial navigator on developers.sap.com, but do you also all know the Generative AI on SAP AI Core tutorial group? If you don't, and if you're interested in AI and especially Generative AI and how that works with SAP, you should definitely check out those tutorials as well, because there are a lot of cool tutorials on the orchestration service, on Generative AI Hub in general, which models you can use. And there are over 40 large language models from all the different large language model providers out there. And you can just compare them very easily with the orchestration service and see which model fits your use case. You will find tutorials on how to build a RAG use case with HANA Vector Store, how to use the grounding module of the orchestration service, and all kinds of other really cool tutorials. And the best thing about these tutorials is that for almost all tutorials, you will always find 5 examples. So one example on how to use the API calls in general, one example on how to use the SAP AI Launchpad, so the UI, one on the Java SDK, one on the JavaScript SDK, and one on my favorite, on the Python SDK. And especially if you're interested in the Python SDK, I can also highly recommend the SAP Help website, which I'm also going to link in the notes. And there are also a lot of cool examples there that you can try out regarding the data masking or the content filtering or also the grounding module of the orchestration service. Yeah, so make sure you check those out and let me know what you think. I think these tutorials will definitely help you to get started with generative AI at SAP. Hello, ABAP developers. I have an interesting news to share. The ABAP Cloud Developer Trial 2023 initial shipment is now available on Docker. It is free downloadable ABAP platform on SAP HANA 2.0. It's pre-configured with SAP Fiori Launchpad, SAP Cloud Connector, front-end and back-end system connections, roles, and also some sample applications. The ABAP license that comes along with the Docker image will last for 3 months, and therefore it is important to download and import the license. So what can you expect in the 2023 edition? First, ABAP Cloud, including RESTful Application Programming Model. ABAP Cloud is a new development model to create cloud-ready and upgrade-stable extensions. So there are many innovations in the area of ABAP Cloud, which includes RAP, ABAP CDS, OData, SAP Fiori Elements, Transport Organizer, and many more. Second, ABAP Git, which is a tool to import and export code between ABAP systems. Third highlight is SAP Cloud Connector, which will help you to connect between the SAP BTP applications and on-premise systems. Fourth, custom code migration with ABAP Test Cockpit. So the trial is pre-configured to run as a central check system, which will check your custom code before the migration. Fifth, Git enabled change and transport system, so you can use Git to store your development objects. So all the information about how to pull the Docker image and the highlights has been explained by our friend Julie Plummer in the blog post. Kindly check it out.
Code Connect is next month in July. It's 4 days of learning and networking goodness in the form of Code Jams on the Monday, UI5Con on Tuesday, Recap on Wednesday, and HANA TechCon on Thursday. And the latest news is that the agendas, or if you're a Latin purist like me, the agendae, are available for all 3 of the 1-day events. So check them all out. There's some amazing talks and amazing sessions from many of my heroes. And if you're going to Code Connect, I'll see you there. I'll put a link to the Code Connect website in the description.